SpaceX is continuing to edge towards the next launch of its Crew Dragon spacecraft, with the vehicle's parachute system the latest critical component to be put through its paces. SpaceX has experienced a couple of hiccups since docking an unmanned Crew Dragon capsule with the International Space Station back in March. Engine testing the following month then ended in a launchpad explosion, which follow-up investigators revealed to be the result of a leaky valve. A perhaps less dramatic failure also came in April, as SpaceX continued testing the spacecraft's parachute system that will be responsible for bringing any astronauts aboard safely back down to Earth. This test run took place with one of the SpaceX Crew Dragon's four chutes disabled, to test the ability to land using just three in case of emergency. Those three also failed to open properly, which sent SpaceX back to the drawing board to rethink the design. While the test wasn't successful, the data SpaceX gained throughout offered new insights on the structural margins and the ideal configuration, culminating in what the company calls its Mark III parachutes. In this video, Engineering Today will discuss SpaceX's upgraded Crew Dragon Mark III parachutes, which breeze through 13 drop tests. SpaceX achieves a key milestone in safety testing of Crew Dragon spacecraft. Let's get started. SpaceX tested the third iteration of the parachute system on its Crew Dragon human spacecraft. While the twice-revised system had malfunctioned in the past, SpaceX has demonstrated that its latest Mark III Crew Dragon parachutes will work even if things don't go quite to plan. SpaceX said November 3rd that it has now carried out 13 consecutive successful tests of the new parachute design for its Crew Dragon spacecraft after overcoming initial problems with it. SpaceX is making an effort to keep the public up to date on how testing is going. On Twitter, the company showed off a short video clip of the latest test of the Mark III parachutes it's developing in cooperation with airborne systems. The latest test demonstrated the parachute system's ability to land the spacecraft safely in the unlikely event that one of the four main parachutes fail, SpaceX said. That's a pretty big milestone for SpaceX to launch NASA astronauts aboard Crew Dragon, as it beats a goal that CEO Elon Musk had set last month. This is a big step for SpaceX's plan to launch NASA astronauts aboard Crew Dragon. Last month, NASA Administrator Jim Bridenstine visited SpaceX headquarters in Hawthorne, California, where he and SpaceX CEO Elon Musk held a press conference to discuss their progress on the commercial crew program. They're on the same page when it comes to development of Crew Dragon. They both emphasize the importance of passing all safety tests before astronauts get on board. At that event, Musk said that he felt SpaceX was aiming to do at least 10 successful tests of its revised Mark III parachute system in a row before any astronauts fly with the system in use. "We certainly want to get at least on the order of 10 successful tests in a row before launching astronauts," Musk said at the time. So that seems like where the behavior of the parachutes is consistent is across 10 successful tests. At the time, Musk added that they were anticipating to get to the 10 successful tests prior to the end of the year. So managing 13 definitely fits with that schedule, and in fact seems to be a rare occasion where SpaceX is actually ahead of the often optimistic timelines that Musk sets as targets. A SpaceX spokesperson said November 3rd the test in the video took place October 31st. It was the first time that SpaceX tested Mark III parachutes simultaneously with the previous 12 successful tests, each involving a single parachute. SpaceX announced last month it was working on the new Mark III parachute design, intended to provide higher margins of safety than the earlier Mark II design. SpaceX Crew Dragon's parachutes, earlier made of nylon, have been modified to a xylon-based material. Xylon is an extremely durable polymer material developed by Stanford University, 1.6 times more durable than Kevlar, and provides the lines used in the parachute around 3 times the strength of nylon. Along with a change in material, SpaceX also changed the pattern of stitch on the parachute to improve its weight balance and distribution. "We think the Mark II parachutes are safe, but the Mark III parachutes are possibly 10 times safer," Elon Musk said at an October 10th event at the company's Hawthorne, California headquarters with NASA Administrator Jim Bridenstine. "I think that the Mark III parachutes, in my opinion, are the best parachutes ever, by a lot." Testing of those new parachutes, though, did not start well, SpaceX acknowledged. The company said the latest test was the 15th for the Mark III parachutes. The first two tests, reaching involving a single parachute, were not successful. A SpaceX spokesperson said those first two tests involved loads much higher than what the parachute would see in a normal operation. As a result, these two development tests resulted in failures that were addressed with design reinforcements that have proven robust in subsequent testing. SpaceX said it worked with airborne systems and rapidly iterated on the Mark III parachute design, carrying out 12 single parachute tests over 7 days prior to the three parachute test. There was a little discussion at the committee meeting on parachute testing, despite the emphasis NASA was placing on that part of SpaceX's commercial crew work. "The highest priority has been the parachutes," Bridenstine said during his October 10th visit to SpaceX. "Elon has told me, and he's showed me, that that's where their priority is. They're setting as much resources and manpower as they can to getting those parachutes ready." There had been industry rumors that at least one recent SpaceX parachute test had failed, which the company's comments about the unsuccessful first two Mark III tests appear to confirm. Neither SpaceX nor NASA would comment on the status of parachute testing last month beyond confirming that Mark III parachute testing was underway. SpaceX said it would continue to work with Airborne on a rapid cadence of testing, seeking to qualify the Mark III parachutes by the end of the year, but did not disclose a target in terms of number of tests planned. "We need to get with the Mark III now consistent, repeatable performance," Bridenstine said at SpaceX. "We could see as many as 10 drop tests between now and the end of the year. It wasn't clear if those 10 tests would involve the complete system, which uses 4 parachutes, or the testing of a smaller number of parachutes as in the recent series of tests." He said more tests might be needed if the performance of the Mark III parachutes was significantly different from the earlier Mark II designs. "We're just going full tilt on the Mark III parachutes," Musk said at the event with Bridenstine. "People think that parachutes look easy, but they're definitely not easy." Musk said that the SpaceX Crew Dragon could be ready for its first crewed Demo 2 test flight in Q1 of 2020. Before that happens, however, SpaceX still has to perform static fire tests of the Crew Dragon abort engine. During the last such test in April, an anomaly caused an uncrewed capsule to explode. If that goes to plan, SpaceX would then perform an in-flight abort test demonstration that astronauts would be able to escape alive in the event of an explosion or other launch problems. During that test, an uncrewed Crew Dragon capsule will launch atop a Falcon 9 rocket at Kennedy Space Center. Shortly after liftoff, the capsule's Super Draco thrusters are supposed to blast it a safe distance from the rocket. If all that works, and that's a big if, NASA and SpaceX could start running the crucial Demo 2 tests to the International Space Station with test flight crew aboard. Both NASA and SpaceX have expressed optimism about getting an actual crewed flight off the ground early next year, provided everything else in terms of testing requirements goes smoothly between now and then. Bridenstine said, "We're getting very close and we're confident that in the first part of next year, we'll be ready to launch American astronauts on American rockets." If all goes well, NASA won't have to hitch rides on Russian ships any longer. It would mark the start of a new era in U.S. spaceflight. We just have to wait a little longer. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.